In the previous video, we discussed two special types of angle modulation, frequency modulation and phase modulation. And we saw that in phase modulation, the phase is linearly proportional to m of t, while the frequency will be linearly proportional to m dot of t. In the frequency modulation, the frequency will be the one that is linearly proportional to m, and the phase will be proportional to the integration. These two special types are two special types of the general angle modulation. In general, angle modulation can be done by processing m of t using any processing technique. And if we limit our processing to linear systems, in general, angle modulation can be done by passing m of t through a linear system with impulse response h of t, and then using this to do an angle modulation, and then using this to modulate the angle. This is the general form of angle modulation. You process m of t using any linear system. This is even not the general form. This is after we limit our focus to linear systems. In general, you can process m of t using any system, not necessarily linear, not necessarily time invariant, but here we are going to limit our focus to linear time invariant system to get a general or a bigger picture of angle modulation. So in general, when you pass m of t through h of t, you are going to get a convolution between m and h, and then you use this convolution to do angle modulation, okay, to get a signal that looks like a cosine omega ct plus m of t convolution with h of t. I'm not sure if this is clear or not, but we are going to do it. Let me write it here again. So I'm going to get the signal here as a cosine omega ct, and then we are modulating the angle with m of t convolution with h of t, which also can be written as a cosine omega ct plus, what's the convolution between m and h? It's the integration from minus infinity to infinity, m of tau h of t minus tau d tau. This is the bigger picture of angle modulation when we limit our attention or our focus to linear time invariant systems. Fm and Bm can be considered as two special cases of this. How's that? Let's, for example, take h. Let's take the system, our impulse response here, to be kb delta. So the impulse response is just a delta Dirac function, multiplied by constant kb. In this case, the convolution between m and h would be convolution with delta. It would be convolution between m of t and constant multiplied by delta. And we said that convolution with delta gives you the signal takes the shift of the delta, right? When you convolve any signal with the delta, the signal takes the shift of the delta. But the delta here has no shift. So the output will be kp m of t. So in this case, the output signal will be, the signal there will be a cosine omega ct plus kp m of t. Which is what? What is this? What's the output signal here in this case? The output signal is exactly the same as the Pm, the phase modulation, a cosine omega ct plus kp m of t. And hence, if you take your system, your linear time invariant system, as kp delta, this will give you the case of Pm, the special case of phase modulation. So phase modulation can be considered as a special case of the general system when you take your linear time invariant system as Kp delta. What about Fm? Let's consider another case. Let's consider another special case. Second special case, let's take our linear time invariant system as Kf unit step. In this case, if you take your h of t as kth unit step, then the output signal will be a cosine omega ct plus integration from minus infinity to infinity m of tau. Kf is a constant, we are going to take it outside, and then u of t minus tau d tau. This integration, we had it before, okay? M of tau, u of t minus tau, d tau. How can we plot u of t minus tau? U of t minus tau, our variable is tau. So u of t minus tau looks like this. 1 from minus infinity to t. Because our variable is tau, we are integrating with respect to tau. So if the variable is tau, this would be a unit step that is flipped and shifted right by t. In this case, unit step u of t minus tau will be 1 from minus infinity to t, and this integration can be written as kf integration from minus infinity to t, from minus infinity to t, 1 multiplied by m of tau. Which is what? What is this? This is exactly the fm. This is exactly the fm signal. So the FM signal can be considered to be a special case of the general system when we choose our linear time invariant system as Kf u of t. The FM can be considered as a special case of the general angle modulation when we choose our linear time invariant system, our processing system, as Kf unit step. Of course, when we implement FM and PM, we don't use this method. This is just a mathematical modeling. This is a mathematical modeling to show you that you are going to process m of t first and then use angle modulation. But of course, when we try to generate pm, for example, we don't pass our m of t through a system with an impulse response delta, because this is impossible to implement in practice. It's impossible to implement a system that has an impulse response delta, right? Delta is not a practical signal, right? So we don't use this method in practice. This is just a mathematical modeling to show you that you are going to process M first and then you do angle modulation. If you want to implement it as a practical implementation, you don't use this method. Actually, what you are going to do is you are going to change the phase depending on M of t directly. So you are not going to use a system that has a delta impulse response or anything, because this is impractical. What you are going to do is you are going to change the phase linearly with m of t using one of the methods that we are going to study later and generate em. But this is just, this broad diagram is just a mathematical modeling. Modeling means you do a model, a mathematical model for a system to represent it mathematically. This is just to keep you, to avoid any confusion that some people, they think that we are going to generate pm or fm using that method. By passing m of t through a system with delta or a system with a unit step. No, this is not what's happening in practice, okay? Okay, so this is general angle modulation, and the two cases that we studied, pm and fm, as two special cases of the general angle modulation. We'll stop here in this video and see you in the next video.